Hello, and welcome to the Product Design Show. I'm Vince Penman.
And I'm Allison Topperwine. Today we are looking at the engineering challenges of high-tech electronics. Have you seen how many features are crammed into a simple cell phone? We now expect our smartphones to store address lists, send emails, manage our calendars, take pictures, browse the web, and even play music and movies. In fact, their original purpose now seems to be their most frustrating shortcoming: conversation.
Companies have finally figured out that phone technology is merging with desktop computing. So watch out for a blizzard of new tablet PCs about to hit your local electronics store.
Some people predict that smartphones and tablets will blend into a form factor like this.
But we want to see smartphones that look like this. Or with a holographic display that looks like this. Okay, maybe without the spandex and glasses.
Photocopiers like smartphones are doing a lot more than they used to. Multifunction copiers now print, fax, and scan, as well as copy. But engineers designing new copiers have to balance the cost of manufacturing against popular features like print speed, memory, and resolution.
Personally, I'm looking forward to the day when my copier also makes lattes. I detect a hint of cinnamon and or toner.
With this blizzard of new features comes pressure on designers and engineers to manufacture more models faster than ever before. Epson, for example, makes hundreds of multifunction printers with thousands of configurations. Epson engineering team uses a direct modeling approach to leverage their existing designs and develop new products faster. The systems they use are Creo's direct modeling tools that let designers modify older designs without having to know anything about their original geometry.
Epson's designs are now also all in 3D, which means that designers can more clearly see and communicate their ideas. This all means that their products get to market faster than ever.
So Vince, maybe we'll see that coffee machine yet.
Don't tease me. Why do you see shutters on houses, but the shutters don't close? Shutters used to serve a purpose, but now they're purely aesthetic. Electronics designers have to deal with this issue all the time. From graphical depictions of dials and gauges to digital cameras that play the sound of an old shutter click. It's called skeuomorphic design, and it helps users leverage their experience using a new device. As the worlds of the physical and the electronic converge, this will become an even more important topic for designers. As for me, I want to play Guitar Hero with a controller that looks like a guitar, not one that looks like a joystick, or worse, a banjo.
In the end, high-tech electronics designers need to quickly bring new products to market to match ever-changing needs. Many of these companies use direct modeling to get products to market faster. You can try direct modeling yourself with a free-for-lifetime version of Creo's direct modeling tools from PTC. Just go to ptc.com/go/modeling-express.
That's a wrap for this week. Next week on the Product Design Show, we'll bring you home and garage power tools.